So what about biology and aggression? It turns out that overall, gender is the best predictor of aggression, men being more likely to commit crimes such as murder, battery, and assault. Culture may also account for some of this, in that aggressiveness may be a product of socialization. It appears that many societies encourage males to be more aggressive than females. But our biology clearly plays a role too. Do you remember when we discussed testosterone in our lesson on motivation and emotion? Well, testosterone is the male sex hormone. However, you'll recall that women also have testosterone, and that's important for our sexual response. We see that testosterone is related to aggression, in that those with higher levels of testosterone correlate positively with the tendency towards aggression and violence. Now, something else that's important to aggression is serotonin. It turns out that low levels of serotonin actually make aggression more likely in humans as well as in other animals. So we see that our biology plays a role in aggression, and our social influences can play a role in aggression. Now, are boys aggressive in the same way as girls? And how does the social world influence our aggressive behaviors? We see that boys may model other boys or men and imitate aggressive behaviors, such as punching, kicking, or so forth. And then as for girls, we do see that they can be physically aggressive. Oftentimes, we see that girls engage in what we call indirect aggression. That's not necessarily hitting or punching, but engaging in behaviors that may exclude an individual. For example, girls may be more likely to talk badly about a person, spread rumors about a person, or make fun of a person, or generally just engage in ways to psychologically hurt an individual. We can argue that the pain of being punched in the face or having rumors spread about you can be very similar. Because as we've said a few times before, the experience of physical and psychological pain both activate the same areas of the brain. Now let's go back to Susan.